despite the fact that Washington State is well underwater. They are spending more than they're taking in, or they're just now trying to balance their budget. And while they exaggerate the size of the deficit, I mean, there is no $5 billion shortfall. They nevertheless still have more commitments than available cash, and they're trying to balance things out. While all this is going on, the government, state government, does next to no contracting out to the private sector that can do just as good a job or even better for less money. And, you know, once again, here we go. It's another union issue when you really get right down to it. We'll explain more in a moment. Right now, State Senator Michael Baumgartner from Spokane, Republican, newly elected, is pushing big time for this. Hello, Senator Baumgartner. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Thanks for having me on the show.
Okay. So you come from the business world. You were probably rather surprised to learn that the state of Washington doesn't contract out much work to the private sector.
That's right, John. You know, as I ran for election, and once I've gone into office, I think it's more than evident that the state is involved in a lot of activities that just aren't core functions of government, and the state is spending money on activities that the taxpayers could get more efficiently and for better value and free up a great deal of money for core functions of government if the state would get out of those activities and look at private sector entities to provide those services.
Okay, now to a lot of people who are driving, listening to what you just said, they said, well, what does he mean? Give a couple of examples of how the state of Washington is spending money, more money than they need to, for essential work.
Well, I guess, you know, the best example, and one that the man on the street can certainly identify with immediately, is the good old state printer. And the idea, I think everyone can understand, is that the state doesn't need to be in the printing business and could be devoting the resources, the salaries, and the effort that goes into providing printing services for the state at a much more cost-effective manner by having that outsourced. Another great example that any business owner would understand would be back office IT services.
You know, explain that.
Any medium, even small, medium-sized business typically does not house and host its own IT services, its own email services, its own data services. Those things are typically outsourced so that the business can specialize in what it does best, and an IT company specializes in that IT portion. The state should be specializing in what it does best, what it needs to do, which is education, building roads, and essential government services. And the state doesn't need to have its own email system or its own far-ranging data server farm. We have a lot of good technology companies in this state. We got the state out of those businesses and outsourced it through contracting, we'd have more money for education.
Anything else?
Well, those are some of the big ones. You know what that people can kind of identify with immediately. You know, another issue that I think your listeners could think through is: does the state need to house and care for its own fleet of cars and automobiles, or is that something when a state employee wants to travel somewhere that perhaps a private sector entity, a rental car company, could provide those cars on an ad hoc basis and potentially save money for the state there as well?
Okay, but I want to underscore something here. Everything you're talking about that the state could be contracting to the private sector, you're saying the private sector can do as good a job, so the public wouldn't see a difference in quality, for less money.
I'm saying that's very likely. You know, in the bill that I'm supporting, that I'm running right now, what we're saying is that the state has to investigate that, and if it does save money, then it has to put that into place.
How does the law work currently?
Well, currently, if you remember, up until 2002, there was a provision in state law that prohibited any contracting out. And then the big labor negotiation in 2002 was that in exchange for the public sector unions being granted the ability to negotiate their collective bargaining contracts directly with the governor, that part of that was to allow contracting out, and okay. that contracting out process just hasn't really happened.
We're up against a hard break here, but basically what you're saying is it can happen, but it's more cumbersome than it needs to be, and your bill addresses that.
Yes.
All exactly. right. Senator Baumgartner, thanks very much for joining me for a few minutes here on KOMO News Radio. I appreciate it.
Hey, John, keep up the great work.
All right. Very, very good. Let's speaking of great work, let's see if traffic.